Hello again, everyone. Here is Substance Painter. So let's go to File, New, and we can keep something in the realm of this. It's fine. PBR Metallic Roughness Alpha. One thing, you can bring up your document resolution if you wish. That could help with the details. Let's select the FBX we made from, that we exported from Maya. So it's that one. Just say OK. We can see here, you can change the dynamics here if you wish. You can see that's our big wall that we want to paint. And we also do need to make sure that we have baked our texture sets. So let's just take a look at that here. And I click on texture set. Yours might be up here, just differences in the way mine's laid out here. So let's just scroll down to that and we'll do bake mesh maps. I think, let's see, we might not need ID, but let's just, okay, so let's just bake them. We can always get rid of them later if we don't need anything. Okay, return to painting mode. So now we have the baked textures. That's really great. So we can look at the, so we're in texture sets here. Let's look at layers. Let's add our, we need to add the wallpaper that I downloaded. And just so you know, I downloaded it from Quixel here. So I downloaded some plaster and some wallpaper. You just have to join by signing in. So it's kind of a fun, some fun stuff there. All right. So let's go down to this, let's add in because we don't have, if I search here for wallpaper, wallpaper, I don't think it's, yeah, it doesn't have anything right now. So let's go here and let's go to add resources and we can look in, I put the wallpaper in my source images here. Let's see where, wall, that's what I, oh, that's not what I want. That's what I exported before. Let's see, is it in here? That's the plaster, okay. And this is the wallpaper. Let's look at the albedo. So that's the color, okay. So let's select, let's just start with the wallpaper so you can just see the process. Let's go to open and you see how it says it's undefined. So let's select all of them and let's define it by going to, again, let's to make sure they're all selected. Click here and we're gonna choose texture and that looks good. And you're gonna import it into your current session, import. Great, and then you can see there it is, that looks great. We can go ahead and make a layer if we want to, or we can also import our plaster in the back here. So let's go to plaster. Okay, I think I forgot to rename that one, but that's okay. And say okay, make sure they're all selected and go to undefined and texture again. Import into current session, import, and there you go. So let's make a layer, fill layer, and we can drop the, I'm just gonna bring this down a little bit. We can drop the color into, so that's the plaster albedo. We can drop that into the base color. You can see it's kind of big, so you can kind of tile it out if you wish, or you can change that to physical size, and we could play around with the tiling there. You could rotate it depending on how you want it to be. Maybe type in a number if you want there. We could, you know, play around the offset. And we can, let's see, this is the plaster, what's that one? That's, I think, the normal. Let's drag that into the normal color. And this is the rough, we can add that to the rough. So again, let's see. I'm not the best, I have to admit. Let's see, you can also repeat horizontally. You could play around with that as well. You could just have no repeat. Yeah, so Offset is that. Let's see if it's offset that way. Yeah, it looks pretty good. So then we want to add another fill layer for the wallpaper. So for that one, let's just look for wallpaper since I did name it that. And for this one, you can add the base color is that. We might want to rotate it though. Let's see, rotation. Again, you can type in 90 if you wish here. And you can also scale it down so it's just this, just the size of what we want it to be. Okay, so let's put the plaster over the wallpaper for a moment. And we're gonna also import some cracks that I have here. If we click back into source materials, you can see I have these exposed cracks, which I made, some of these, one or two of them I made one out of that. This is the one I made out of that. So let's import these, let's see. And I'm just gonna grab all of them and we're gonna say open. Instead of texture now, we're gonna import these as alpha and into our current session, import. So there we have those. So that's nice. And I could show you in a different video how to make those. Okay, so let's add a new fill layer for our cracks. And we're gonna do everything here, turn off everything but height. We just want the height to work. And for now, let's just make it so that the height is -1. It's gonna we're gonna have it go inward. And then let's take a look here and we're gonna right mouse click and we're gonna add a black mask. I know you can't see it, it's above the video there, but it's right above add bitmap. So add black mask. Okay, and so that now there's our black mask. Now let's double click on one of these to create it, make it into a brush. And you can change anything here. Also, you want to turn off any of these jitters. You can play with the scale if you wish. Let's see. You can also mess around with the angle of the brush. Okay, so I'm just gonna create one like that, and then maybe I'll create. Again, you're welcome to change the angle. And let's do another one. Maybe we'll make it a little bigger. And let's put that one there. Okay. So you can plate as many as you wish there. So these are made on this full layer here. So let's right mouse click because we're going to add it to our plaster layer. We're going to copy the mask and then click here and we want to paste into a mask here. And now you can see that I'm just gonna move this over a little bit. You can see the way that it's making it look like it's pushed in a little bit. You can always go into there and mess around with some of the sizes there if you wish. So anyway, so and if you added some more to this one, you'd want to copy it again. So okay, great. So now we have those and that looks pretty good. Let's see what would happen if we add some dirt to this. So I'm gonna add another fill layer. I'm just gonna put it on top of that one and let's see, let's make another black mask. And on that black mask, we're actually gonna look for some masks. And we're gonna drop, maybe we want some, just looking for a dirt mask. I'm gonna put it in the fill layer. And you can say it's pretty intense there. So you can play around with the size. Oops, actually you have to check here for mask editor. And then you can do it some blur if you wish. You can play around with the global balance of it. You can go in and do individual textures because it's made up of a couple different textures here. You can play with ambient occlusion, curvature, which I think you can kind of see it's affecting the right hand side a little bit more there. World space normals, you know, enjoy playing with these however you think it works. You can sort of pump up a lot of these and then go back to the global balance and bring it back down, whichever you think works best. Let's see, you can also mess around here if you wish. And once again, you could play with the global balance here. This just kind of randomly seeds it. All right, it's, you know, it's not that bad. Maybe it needs a little less contrast. Okay, so we can add another one of these. If you just duplicate this one, duplicate layer, and then you get rid of the mask, so we can add a different one to it. So let's take a look. Dirt soft edges. What's this one? Dirty splashes. Let's just take a look. Okay, so it's really, really big. Oops. Again, you can always turn off one of these if you don't like it. Just make sure to double click it, and you could you can play around with the tiling here. Let's turn it back on. And see what happens when we rotate it. You could also bring down the opacity here. If you don't like it, you could bring down the contrast, I mean the balance, bring up or down the contrast brush pattern. That's kind of interesting. And cracks. Let's see. Rotation, hardness. I'm not sure how that works. Let's see. And then if you don't like what you did, you could always restore your details. And let's make that an even 45 perhaps. Okay. So, yeah, as you can see, there's all sorts of things you can do here. I'm going to make another, duplicate it and get rid of that one. Let's see what else we could add here. Stains, surface worn. What does that look like? Wow, that's really intense. Let's see if, oops, remember you have to surface stains, mask editor. Let's look at the global balance. Woo, it's really intense. Texture one, we could see if we can take some of these down. Oh, there's, okay, there's that one. Curvature is interesting there. Let's see. Thickness. Let's see what happens when we press random seed here and play with the balance. See what happens when we add a little contrast with brush pattern. That's really interesting, huh? Okay. Again, get that, so you can play with that. So there's so many things you can play with. Let's, maybe we take a look, we want like an edge here as well. We want to have a rough edge. So let's duplicate that layer and let's get rid of this one. Let's try moss. And again, take a look at that. Let's go to the very top here and you could bring down the level. But yeah, okay. So you could keep playing around with this if you would like. Let's go up to File, Export Textures. And we want to, let's see, I'm just going to make them into PNGs. I'm going to place them into, I don't want it to go into there because I'll forget about it and it'll fill up my hard drive. So I'm going to look at my desktop and I'm going to look on my wall and source images. And let's place them here. I think it'll be called wall two here. So open and let's just export those and export. Okay, and let's just see if that worked. I think it did. Let's take a look here in our wall folder and source images, wall two. Yeah, so there's our base color. You can see the edges are kind of funky, but that's okay because we don't really use those. It's gonna be fine. So we could close out of Substance Painter. I'm not gonna save that session. And then you could reopen up Maya. Okay, so here we are in Maya again. Let's add a new material. Let's do an Arnold AI standard. And let's take a look. We'll add, excuse me, the color here. Let's take a look at what we have. It's the wall to base color. And let's see what that looks like. See if it's added correctly. It looks a little dark here, but if we render it, I think it'll be okay. Yeah, it looks fine. I think again, I kind of overdid it. It was easier to see how much I overdid it here. I'm also going to delete my history there. Okay, so you could also choose your roughness map here. Let's take a look at that, and we'll grab our wall to roughness. Okay, let's also go down to our geometry. And let's go to our bump map. Let's make a file. Let's try that as a tangent space normal. Let's look here for where we're gonna add the file. Wall to blend. Okay, so let's see. I think that's all I'm gonna add here. I think I'm gonna take down my specularity so it's not so shiny. And again, let's take a look at how it renders. I might go back into Substance. I probably should have saved that file, and I would make it so that it's not quite as crazy here. Let's see how well it's rendering if we go kind of close up. Actually, it looks pretty good. I also am kind of in a slightly low size here, so let's bring that up to 1080, and let's just see what it looks like. Looks better. All right, so that's it for now.